This session is about creating text objects in an AutoCAD drawing using the data present in an Excel sheet. Using a simple formula in Excel, we can create thousands of text objects within no time. Here in this Excel sheet, column D is having the text to be inserted into an AutoCAD drawing.
Column B and C contain the coordinates for the same. To export this data into an AutoCAD drawing, other ways to create text using this data in AutoCAD, we have to convert this data into the language of AutoCAD. To create a text object in AutoCAD, text command is used. In the command bar, type in hyphen text, then space, then the coordinates where the text is to be inserted. Let it be 1000, 1000. Then we need to specify the height of the text. Let the height be 10. Now the rotation of the text. Let it be 0. Now the content of the text to be inserted. Let it be Excel and CAD. And we have created a text object Excel and CAD here at 1000, 1000 with a text height of 10 and 0 rotation. Once again, hyphen text space 1200, 1200. Let the height of the text be
30,
rotation be 45.
Text to be inserted is XNC. And we just created a text called XNC with a height of 30, rotated at 45 degrees. Here in the command history, you can see the commands and parameters which we use to create those text objects. Now back to our worksheet. We have seen the syntax for creating text in AutoCAD. Hyphen, text, space, x coordinate, comma y coordinate, space, height, space, rotation, space, content. Hyphen text space x1 comma y1 space 10 space 0 space text1 will create a text object called text1 of height 10 at x1 y1 with 0 degree rotation.
Repeating this statement 10 times with different values for x and y coordinates and content will create 10 discrete text objects.
For creating text present in the column D at coordinates given in the columns B and C, we will join this data using concatenate function.
In the column F,
equal concatenate, double quotes, hyphen, text, space, double quotes, comma, B2, that is the x coordinate of the text to be inserted, comma, double quotes, comma, double quotes, comma, C2, that is y coordinate of the text, comma, double quotes, space. Here we have to specify the height of the text. Let it be 10, space, then the value for rotation of the text. Let it be 0, space, double quotes, comma, then the content, T2, that is the text to be inserted.
And we have combined the XY coordinates and content for the text here. I will drag this formula to the downward cells. Copy this data range. Back to our AutoCAD drawing. In the command bar, paste the data. And we just created 10 text objects at different points with different content by doing that.
Zoom to extents. And these are the new objects created. Here in the command history, you can see the statements which we used for creating these text objects.
We can control the height and rotation of text with the use of cell references inside the function.
Let the height be 50, rotation be 45. Now the height will be referred to cell I3 and rotation will be referred to cell I4.
By default, cell references in Excel are relative and we have to make it absolute.
And every time when I change the values in cell I3 and I4, the output in the column F will be updated.
Copy the data. Back to AutoCAD. Paste the data in the command bar.
And here we have created 10 text objects with a text height of 25, rotated at 40 degrees.
Now with a large data set. These are the FRLs and OGLs, otherwise finished road levels and original ground levels of a highway project. And I am going to import this data into AutoCAD.
Equal, double quotes, hyphen, text, space, double quotes, ampersand A2. Here the change will become the X coordinate of the text. Ampersand, double quotes, comma, 100, Y coordinate will be fixed to 100, text height will be 5, space with a rotation of 90 degree, space, double quotes, ampersand, B2, content of the text, that is the finished road level. The same formula can be used for plotting OGLs. We need to change the cell reference for content. Then the value for Y coordinate, we'll change it to 150 to avoid overlapping. Copy this formula to the adjacent cells downwards. For plotting these FRLs and OGLs, I will open a new drawing. We'll create a new layer for FRLs. We'll change the color to red. We'll copy the data from column E. Paste it in the command bar. And you can see here, FRLs are plotted. Now for plotting OGLs, we'll create a new layer. We'll change the color to green. We'll copy the data from column F. Paste it in the command bar. and we have plotted the OGLs. If you want to extract the details of text objects present in an AutoCAD drawing, you can use a macro for that. I will show you how to do that. Load the macro. Execute the macro. Select the text objects. Press enter. And the details of all those text objects present in this drawing, that is coordinates along with text, are extracted to this text file. To know more about this method, please watch my video on the same. You can download the workbook shown in this video from my blog. For feedback and discussion, please make use of the comment section. And those who are visiting this channel for the first time, subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon so that you won't miss any video releases. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.